Hey guys, Day here. I farmed nothing but low-level delves for 10 hours straight as efficiently as I could and tracked my profits. In this video, I'll talk about my loot, the general concept of low-level delve farming, and how you can maximize currency gain if you want to give this a try yourself. Timestamps for different segments are in the description. I used 5 gilded sulphite scarabs to farm up sulphite, put over 500% movement speed on my character, and then started my 10-hour run. In those 10 hours, I profited over 4,500 chaos when you minus the cost of the scarabs, earning well over 400 chaos per hour, making this one of the best solo currency farming strategies in the game. For a full breakdown of all my loot and detailed profit calculations, I prepared an Excel sheet with a link in the description, as I won't go into all the details of my loot here. Most of the currency gain comes from selling fossils, as you can see in these stash tabs. I also picked up 3 exalts from hidden opulence chests and one-off monsters, but I did not include those exalts in my profit calculations, so we can see what hourly profits look like with atrocious RNG. Aside from high hourly profits, the great thing about low-level delving is that it requires little time and currency investment to get the ball rolling. You don't need to shape your atlas, build rivalry connections in Syndicate, roll sextants, or anything else. At most, you need to do your Nico daily quest for sulfite or use a sulfite scarab in a map, but since low-level delving costs so little sulfite, you can delve for hours at a time with relatively little investment. If your character can move fast and survive death 60 or so, you can do this strategy without any issues at all. At the core of low-level delving is hunting down fractured walls off to the sides of the cart path and looting the spoils within. Identify long stretches of road, start the cart moving, and then run into the darkness to find fractured walls to blow up and loot. Once the loot has been obtained, I run back to the cart and continue along the pathway looking for more fractured walls. At a fundamental level, the delve map is arranged into square tiles of equal size. If you pay close attention to the different biome colors in the background of the delve map and how they are divided, this becomes very clear. Along the path of the cart, you can either have a tile with a delve monster encounter, or you can have an empty tile. In every single empty tile, you are guaranteed to find a fractured wall hiding within the darkness. For example, between these two delve monster encounters, the path of the minecart travels through 3 empty tiles. Therefore, you can expect to find 3 fractured walls along the path, one in each square tile. While farming in the darkness is fairly easy once you've maxed your darkness resistance and put some movement speed on your character, optimizing the amount of currency gain per hour requires a little bit more concerted effort. Firstly, you have to farm the right biomes. Fractured walls in the magma fissure biome, with the red backgrounds, contains common fossils that are worth about 5.5 chaos on average at the time of this recording. Every other biome, like the blue frozen hollow or the purple fungal caverns, contains common fossils that are worth around 3.5 chaos or less on average. That means while you are in the magma fissures, you are earning about 50% more currency from fossils, which really adds up over time. As a general rule of thumb, you want to avoid the abyssal depths biome due to the complete lack of valuable fossils. Every other biome provides great profit too, just not as much as the magma fissure. When you're choosing which route to go on, longer is better. You want to minimize time spent in the delve monster encounters and maximize the fractured walls you run into between them. I personally stayed between depth 40 and 64 while performing this strategy. I tried to avoid going beyond depth 64, as the sulfite cost suddenly increased by 50%, which is obviously not a good thing if you are trying to maximize the value of your sulfite. Finally, I want to spend a bit of time discussing how important movement speed is in this farming strategy. I think having above 350% movement speed makes low-level delving feel fantastic, and the faster you go, the smoother farming feels. Since the monsters are relatively weak at low-level delves, you can afford to lose out on life and damage to increase your movement speed. And at the end of this video, I'll briefly talk about my own build if you are curious. Aside from maximizing your efficiency inside the delves, one of the biggest determinants of how much money you make is how you price and sell your fossils and resonators. In PoE, time is money, which applies not only to you when you are farming, but to the people who will be buying your fossils. Players will pay a premium for high-demand fossils and resonators that are available in bulk, as it saves them a lot of time compared to buying items from different people one at a time. For example, if you were selling two socket resonators, the common price you see is 1 chaos each. However, in bulk quantities, they can sell for 3 or 4 times their normal value, as you can see in my transaction here, selling each one for 4 chaos each. A similar principle applies to fossils. For example, enchanted fossils sell one at a time for about 7 chaos, but I'm selling 60 enchanted fossils for 10.5 chaos each because I have a bulk supply. Do this for every single highly desired fossil, and your currency gain is completely different than without. To properly price your bulk fossils and resonators, set a minimum stock of 10 or so on the trade website, observe the value of the other bulk sales there, and then set your prices accordingly, not by the value of individual sales. And as a small tip, if you literally have no other use for your Azurite, you can buy resonators from Nico and sell them for additional currency as well, although I didn't personally do that. Now, if you want to farm for elongated periods of time, maximizing the value of sulfite scarabs when you farm sulfite is essential. The amount of sulfite earned on a Nico node is dependent on the inherent quality rolled on the map and the tier of the map. Therefore, if you use them on a tier 16 map, rolled with at least 130% quantity through Val Orbs, with 2 additional sacrifice fragments to boost up quantity, you can expect to gain an average of 10,000 sulfite across many uses of Gilded Sulfite Scarabs. I got a lot of questions about builds in my last Syndicate farming video, and I'm probably going to get a lot of questions about builds in this video as well, but at the basic level, when it comes to the build you want to use, you basically just want to stick as much mobility on your character as possible. In the description, I've linked a path of building for my own character if you want to look for yourself and see the nitty-gritty details, but I'm not really doing anything too special. Of note, I have a lot of investment in my character, but you don't need nearly as much investment to get a high amount of movement speed. Personally, I've got 58 movement speed from 7 League Steps, 18% from Car Reward, 50% from a Queen of the Forest when at 45,000 evasion with a Jade Flask of Reflexes, 20% from Devoto's Devotion, 16% from my bow, 36% from my belt, and Rampage from Shadows and Dust for more fun and movement speed in battle. In my tree, I've got 2 Transcendent Spirit Jewels for more movement speed, and a Watcher's Eye with 15% movement speed while affected by Grace. I use a Warlord's Mark on hit for mana and life leech, and linked a secondary tornado shot with life gain on hit to help survive in darkness when I want to conserve flares. You don't need all these things to have a character that can move fast, but the more movement speed you have, as long as you can survive, the better. Now, in this video, I've talked about a lot of things you can do to maximize your currency gain per hour and play super efficiently, but that's all only really necessary if you're trying to push how much money you can make in a given time frame. In reality, you don't have to focus on magma fissures, get 500% movement speed, or sell items strictly in bulk. You know, low-level delving is going to make tons of profit even at a very casual pace. And from a personal viewpoint, I found it more fun and engaging than syndicate farming because there is greater possibility for those big drops to occur, and easier than high-level mapping because there's no map rolling or serious prep involved. Furthermore, the feeling of finding a fractured wall with a hidden opulence chest, resonator trove, or triple fossil nodes behind it is truly satisfying. If you want to get an idea of what this farming looks like over a longer period of time, or get a better understanding of it, I've done an hour of live commentary, and the video is linked in the description. In that hour, I earned about 420 chaos as well, so it serves as a pretty good proof of concept for the kind of money you can earn. Hopefully, in this video, I was able to show you something new or pique your interest about low-level delving and currency farming. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below, and I'll do my best to lend a helping hand. In any case, thank you guys for watching, and I'll catch you all next time.